My name is Alicia Howard, and I'm with Columbus Recreation and Parks Department. I'm the Communications and Marketing Specialist, and today we are at Thompson Community Center for the Buster Douglas Boxing Invitational Show. So I work for the Columbus Recreation and Parks Department, and in my role as Communications and Marketing Specialist, I support all the media relations, communications, public relations for our 29 community centers, as well as our therapeutic recreation program, our outdoor education program, and our youth and adult sports. Sure. So as I mentioned, we have 29 community centers, and so you get a variety of classes and offerings depending on which center you go to. But many of our programs focus on the arts. Many of our programs focus on fitness, whether that be fitness classes or just having the ability to go to a gym for an affordable price. Outside of that, we have things like boxing, which we have to showcase today. And as I mentioned, the arts. So we offer everything from ceramics to painting and drawing. And we also have a cultural arts center that offers many different art classes every year throughout the year. So that's the great thing about Columbus Recreation and Parks Department. You can pretty much find a program for anyone of any age. While we have community centers that are specifically dedicated to our seniors, so we have Martin Janis, and we also have Gilley Community Center. All of our centers have offerings for whether it be seniors down to 2 and 3 year old youth.
Find the strawberry and help feed the need and feed yourself in the process. Hello, I'm Mayor Andrew Genther. Through private nonprofit support, the Columbus Recreation and Parks Department will be taking its strawberry food truck to area events this summer to help fund activities and meals for children. Local celebrity chefs will be taking over the food truck at each location, so you'll never get the same meal twice. To find out where the truck will be and which chef will be slinging the hash, visit us on Facebook.
So we know that, community centers bring people together, and it does a good job of broadening the horizons of so many people and offering things that maybe they can't get access to for free a lot of times in other places. And so it really just brings together a sense of community, depending on which community you're in, and just being able to get exposure to many different opportunities, whether it be fitness classes or drawing or health benefits or whatever the case may be. So you don't have to pay to go to the center in and of itself. We do have leisure cards, and leisure cards only cost $1. You go to any community center, get your picture taken, and you'll get a leisure card, and that's what you use to register for classes or activities that you want to partake in. So some of our activities you would have to pay, and we do that through our website on ActiveNet, but there are some programs that are free, so it really just depends on what you're looking for.